Live, local, now. The news starts right now with breaking news.
Good afternoon. I'm Cyria Sandlin, and we are following breaking news out of Hampton County. We have just learned prominent South Carolina attorney Alec Murdoch has turned himself in to authorities. An arrest warrant was out for Murdoch on charges of conspiracy to commit insurance fraud. This all comes just a few hours after a bond hearing was held for the suspect accused in the shooting of Murdoch. The South Carolina Law Enforcement Division says Murdoch conspired with 61-year-old Curtis Smith to try and help Murdoch commit suicide. Murdoch told investigators Smith shot him so his son Buster Murdoch could collect his $10 million life insurance policy. We have been covering this for you all day long. WTOC's Tyler Mannion joining us now live in Hampton County, just a few steps away from where Murdoch surrendered. So, Tyler, what can you tell us? We continue our coverage now as we have just learned there is a new criminal investigation involving the Murdoch family. Listen to this. The death of their housekeeper, Gloria Satterfield, in 2018 is now under investigation. According to a Hampton County court document, she died after a trip and fall accident. Now, the South Carolina Law Enforcement Division is now investigating her death. According to SLED, Satterfield's death was not reported to the coroner at the time, and an autopsy was never performed. Agents also say the cause of death on Satterfield's death certificate says she died of natural causes, and investigators say that is not consistent with the alleged trip and fall accident. This is just one of five open cases involving the Murdoch family. We continue to follow all of them. We have added the timeline of events to our website, WTOC.com. Just look for the Murdoch case page. 12:04, taking a live look outside from our WTOC downtown Savannah sky cam. We've already seen some showers pop up, Dave, and unfortunately, we're not in the clear yet. WTOC's chief meteorologist Dave Turley joining us now with your forecast.
That's right, sorry. Hey to you. And
all right, thanks, Dave. We also have a WTOC update this morning at a shooting on the Statesboro campus of Georgia Southern University last night. University officials tell us no one is involved that is affiliated with Georgia Southern. Now, university police say the shooting happened after an accident off campus at the intersection of Georgia Avenue and Lanier Drive. They say that accident led to road rage. A chase happened and shots were fired at the victim's car near Kennedy Hall. The suspected shooter then drove away from the campus. Police say the victim was injured but was not directly hit by gunfire. The investigation is ongoing. Let's take a quick look now at the latest COVID-19 data for Georgia and South Carolina. South Carolina just reported its single highest day for deaths due to COVID yesterday. DHEC reports 110 confirmed deaths, 28 probable deaths. That is alongside 2,400 confirmed cases and 800 probable cases. Now, Georgia reporting some of its lowest numbers since the beginning of August, but that's still more than 6,000 new cases yesterday. We want to let you know that a life-saving COVID-19 treatment is in short supply and high demand. Because of that, the government is changing the way the treatments are distributed. It's called the COVID-19 monoclonal antibody treatments. They're used to help people at high risk for severe COVID illness. Healthcare providers will no longer be able to order the treatments directly. From now on, the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services will determine each state's weekly allotment. The number of treatments is being based on use and the number of new COVID cases. Well, after the state receives those treatments, the Georgia Department of Public Health will identify which sites in the state get the treatment and how much. There are 136 locations in Georgia where the antibody treatments are being administered. There are 4 sites in Chatham County, 2 in Liberty County, where COVID-19 hospitalizations are at an all-time high.